Good morning, my dear students. Do you know which are the important religions in our country? Hinduism, Islam, Christianity, Sikhism, Jainism, Buddhism. These are the major religions which are existing now in India. Today we are going to study about the changes in the religion from the medieval period. During the medieval period, there were many changes happened in the religious beliefs and traditions. We are going to discuss it in this video. Before that, what is religion? Religion is people's belief in the divine. They believe that there is a power which controls everything. And religion is a supernatural agency to God. Okay. So it's a personal choice. All of us have the right to believe in any religion. And in the medieval period, there were many changes in the religious traditions. The beliefs were connected with the social economic conditions or social economic organization. Our beliefs are connected with always our economic and social conditions. Likewise, in the medieval period also, there were great influence of economic and social conditions over religion. The first change was in Hinduism. Okay, there were prevailing the Hinduism and the major changes happened in Hinduism. Hinduism became stronger in India and many new deities came to be worshipped. Look at the word deities. Deity means God or goddess. So many new gods came to be worshipped. They began to worship many new gods and goddesses. Okay. And they started worshipping the idols. And the royal families, wealthiest families, constructed many temples. So we can see many temples in the temples as the monuments of the medieval period now. Okay. So this was the major change in the Hinduism. And the second change in this period was the dominance to Brahmins. Great dominance was given to Brahmins. Why? Let's see. They were very much mastered mathematics and Sanskrit. In the last class, we have studied about Sanskrit language. We have heard about Sanskrit language. I told you it is not a spoken language. It is the language in which the Vedas and prashastis about the kings were written in. So, as the Brahmanas were mastered in Sanskrit, the priests and the upper caste kings and rulers were very much favoring the Brahmins by giving them prizes, cash rewards and houses to dwell, etc. By giving them many offers, the rulers were kept Brahmins with them. For what? To write the prashastis about the rulers. So, Brahmins became an important part of that society. The wealthy persons were supporting Brahmins very much. I have already said that they were given many gifts and cash rewards to Brahmins so as to write their prashastis. These people are known as patrons. Patron is an influential and wealthy person who support any other person, such as a learned man or an artist or an craft persons. And these people will have good wealth and these people will support any persons. These are called patrons, and these patrons were supporting Brahmins very much. And the third one is the emergence of idea of bhakti. Since then, the people were worshipping God through priests, okay, and by traditional rituals. But in the medieval period, they started to worship the God from the home itself without the help of priests. They began to pray to God without or do the rituals without. Rituals means pujas and other traditional rituals. Okay, in the olden days, the priests were doing that in the temples. But in the medieval period, idea of bhakti had emerged and they worshipped God from their own houses. These were the changes happened to Hinduism. Okay, and what happened then? A new religion was introduced in the 7th century. During 7th century, a new religion was introduced by the merchants and migrants. The merchants and migrants from Arab nations introduced Islam to India. So, Islam was came to India in the 7th century and it was introduced by merchants and migrants. Okay, the people who are traveling one place to another is called migrants, and these migrants and merchants brought the holy Quranic teachings to our country. That's the emergence of Islam in India. And the Islam is a religion which believe in one God, that is Allah. They believe that everything is safe under Allah and Allah will keep everything safe and happy. He will keep us happy if we believe Him. This was the belief of Islam. And Quran is the holy book of Muslims. We all know that each religion has their own holy books and Quran is the holy book of Islam. And there were two faiths in Islam. Okay. Islam was classified according to their beliefs as Shias and Sunni. It was classified into Shia and Sunni. The belief was on God Allah, but there were changes in the theology and the rituals. Okay. So, on the basis of this, Muslims were classified into Shia and Sunni. There were many patrons for Islam and Ulama. So, Ulama means the religious scholars or the persons who are well known about the Islam and Islamic rituals. They are called Ulamas, and there were many patrons for Islam, Islam and this Ulamas. And this was the another change that happened in the medieval period. The first changes was in Hinduism. Hinduism became stronger and many new god and goddesses were worshipped. And dominance to Brahmins. Brahmins were considered as a superior people in the society. And the bhakti, idea of bhakti has emerged that every person started praying to God from their houses itself. And a new religion were introduced, that is Islam, in the 7th century. That's all for today. Catch you in the next class. Thank you.